A defiant Roy Moore is not only refusing to drop out of the Senate race, he is calling this a spiritual battle. But what do evangelical voters think of all this? Here to discuss now is Albert Mohler. He's the president of the Southern Baptist Theological Seminary. Thank you so much for joining us here on CNN, Mr. Mohler. We appreciate it. Let's talk about this scandal surrounding the Senate candidate Roy Moore is forcing Christian voters in Alabama to make a really tough decision. How is an evangelical Christian voter supposed to choose which is more important, their politics or their faith?
Well, you know, that's a very good question. It's a crisis of conscience that evangelicals are facing right now acutely in Alabama. And, you know, Don, the first thing we have to understand is the severity of these charges. If we're united on anything in terms of moral judgment as a people, surely it is the fact that no 30-year-old man has any business having anything to do with a 14-year-old girl. The sexual abuse, which is all that it can be called, of a minor is something, thanks be to God, even in this morally confused age, there still is a strong consensus is just absolutely wrong.
But a 14, and, 16, or 17-year-old, right?
Absolutely. And, you know, here's the problem, Don. When the autopsy on this is done sometime later, it's going to be, I think, a combination of the severity of the charges. We couldn't imagine charges more severe. But to be honest, from an evangelical conscience perspective, also the inadequacy of Judge Moore's response and his denials. They just were far too elastic to fit the moral importance of these charges. I think many evangelicals are just beginning to understand that. As the evidence piles up, as the charges are made, it's not so much just the credibility of the charges. That's there, of course. But it's also the inadequacy of Judge Moore's denials to date.
Yeah. But I really want to, we don't have much time, but I want to play this. I want to play, this is a clip from an Alabama voter who was asked about this. Play this, please.
At first, you know, I really wasn't sure how I felt about the situation, but then I look at it this way. I don't have the best past. And if it has happened, you know, I believe the good Lord's forgiven him. And he has a right to continue to prove himself. He went to the Lord, whatever, and asked for forgiveness for that and hasn't done anything like that. And since then, I believe that if the good Lord's forgiven him as a Christian, I have to forgive him also.
Okay. All right. I'm just trying to understand how that makes sense, because if he did do it, she said, if he did do it, that would be a criminal offense. Shouldn't he go to jail, right? And maybe she can forgive him instead of becoming a U.S. senator? Like, what is happening here?
Well, the Christian worldview, you know, Don, the scripture, the Christian worldview is really clear on this. The Bible says, if we confess our sins, he, meaning Christ, is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. That's the gospel of Christ. But there are two things here we have to note. First of all, that means confessing that sin and repenting of that sin. There's no biblical notion of being forgiven of sin that one has not confessed and of which one has repented. That's just completely alien from Scripture. But the other thing is that biblical Christianity understands that even though one is forgiven in terms of the grace of God and the blood of Christ, there are still penalties to behavior in terms of the criminal law. And so even though
listen,
we believe
I understand
murderer
that.
Or someone...
I understand that. Yeah. I grew up a Christian, but and I'm still a Christian. But listen, what she is saying is that if he hasn't done it, then he should be forgiven and then should go on to become a U.S. senator. What most people would say, if I, as a Christian, I can forgive him, but this precludes him from becoming a senator and perhaps he should become an inmate. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Well, I'm agreeing with you. I'm saying that biblical Christianity would affirm the consequences of sin in terms of criminal behavior, even as we understand the forgiveness of sin in Christ. Mm-hmm. But I think it's really important that we understand that we're not talking about cheap grace here. We're not talking about the forgiveness of sins just because a sin has been committed. Right. The Bible's very clear about confession and repentance. And at this point, we're talking about allegations that Judge Moore has denied. But he's denied using words that in retrospect are really troubling, like not customary behavior. And, you know, I think even those who have immediately defended Judge Moore in the aftermath, I think seriously minded Christians are really thinking very clearly about this and having not only second but third thoughts. The other good thing that I'm very encouraged about, Don, is that even though in the 2016 there was a real division amongst evangelicals about the election, conservative, biblically minded evangelicals, I think there's a lot more unanimity, a lot more consensus in this case, and I'm thankful for that. There is no groundswell of evangelical leadership, pastors and evangelical leaders, saying this is not a big deal. It is a big deal.
I really enjoyed this conversation, and I appreciate your perspective. Thank you so much for coming on, Mr. Mohler.
Thanks for having me, Don.